Good morning, everybody. My name is Sonia Tijero. I'm a Vedic chef, Ayurveda practitioner, Ayurveda food and nutrition consultant. I'm a Vedic chef because I prepare meals based on the principles of Ayurveda. Well, let's start today to see how we can manage adrenal fatigue through food and herbs. First of all, we are going to identify what are the symptoms that we can experience when we have adrenal fatigue. That is not the regular fatigue because we exercise too much or we didn't sleep. No, we are, the beginning of the day, we wake up tired. We are lack of energy. We are foggy, we cannot think right, we become irritated for minimal things, low libido, we have no desire for life, we have cravings, not only for sweet things, for salty food too. We feel lazy, we don't want to do anything, we lost interest in life. We are experiencing pain in our lower back and the area of the kidneys. So when the stress is there, we don't know how to handle. We don't have tool to cope the stress. So for those who knows Veda Pulse, we have tools in Veda Pulse to identify the adrenal fatigue. And we are going to see which are. First, we are going to identify in the analytics, in the academic, a high Vata. This is Vata. Let me point this, the pointer. Okay, we have Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. You're going to find this in academics. So we have a high Vata here. That is the first thing that we are looking for to see we have fatigue in our adrenal glands. Then we are going to, in the academic too, we are going to check what is the total power. If we, the normal is from 800 to 1500. If we are under 800, yes, that is a sign of adrenal fatigue. In this case, this client, he was in 352.9. That is very low. In the Nidana muscle, we are going to see in the sub doshas, in the Vata dosha, how is Apana and Prana. High Apana and poor Prana, that's going to lead us to adrenal fatigue. Another sign that we are going to find is if the person is in fighting mode. Is fighting mode or flight mode? This person is in a fighting mode. That means that there is a lot of cortisone and a lot of adrenaline in the body. Okay, so we are going to recapitulate this. The other tool that we have is we are going to check in the chakras how is Muladhara, because Apana is related to Muladhara and Svadhisthana, but we need to know how is Muladhara. And we can see in the yellow area that Muladhara is very poor, it's lack of energy. The green area is normal, and in the pink area is tension. So here Muladhara is telling us there is adrenal fatigue. I'm going to come back and explain again this again. And then in the meridian muscles, we are going to check in the eighth channel, that is the channel of the kidneys, if the red line is in the yellow area, that is showing us that is adrenal fatigue presence. Okay, so let's go back to again. High Vata. Then, high apana and low prana. The total power is under 800. The fighting mode, that means there is a lot adrenaline and cortisol in the system. Then we are looking for muladhara. Muladhara is lack of energy. And the last two is in the meridians. We are checking in the eighth meridian, that is the Kinen channel, and the red line is in the yellow area. I'm going to have all the description here that is going to tell you what's going on. Okay, so I prepared a little map with food and herbs to have an idea how to cope the stress through food and herbs. But the first thing that we have to take care of our glands is we have to eliminate the stress. That's the reason we are going to see, well, how can we support that? Another thing is, if you're drinking coffee, coffee is one of the depressor of the adrenal glands. So try to give up on coffee. Try to replace with herbal coffee. I know it's hard. You don't want to think about it, but I always recommend to my client, just put 75% of your coffee with 25% with herbal coffee. After 2 weeks, 1 week, you're going to put 50% your coffee, 50% herbal coffee. Then you're going to reduce 25% the regular coffee and 75% of the herbal coffee. In one point, you are not drinking coffee anymore and you are not going to experience any withdrawal. And you're going to save your adrenal glands, okay? Okay, perfect. The first thing to address the stress is give it to your body omega-3 and omega-6. That is very, very important. So you know that we can find that in ghee, olive oil, salmon, nut, especially almonds and walnut, flaxseed, cheese, chia seed. And then we have to add magnesium and vitamin C. So the first thing that we have to incorporate is green leaves. But we are experiencing bad time balance. Then the green leaves can be raw. The green leaves must be cooked, steamed, boiled, sauteed. You cannot have green leaves raw. So forget about your juicing, forget about your smoothies. We're in winter, at least in the North Hemisphere. So greens must be cooked. All your food must be cooked. It's bad time balance. Sweet potatoes, broccoli. Broccoli must not be raw ever. Here in the United States, people eat raw broccoli and raw cauliflower. That is a no-no. Why? Because they are goitrogenic. That means it's going to paralyze the function of your thyroid. Cucumbers. Then add banana, rich in magnesium, right? Figs, avocado, avena. Avena is oats. Sometimes my Spanish filter. Dates, grains and lentils, quinoa, amaranth, cruciferous, like a cabbage, kale, remember, that is from the same family. Broccoli belongs to this family, so it's not raw. Kale, you cannot have kale raw. It's goitrogenic. That's going to paralyze the action of your thyroid. Then you have beautiful herbs, aromatic, like rosemary, oregano, sage, and cilantro. These are the most beautiful herbs from Ayurveda, like ashwagandha, the best adaptogenic, gotu kola for your brain, to keep you calm. Amalaki, super rich in vitamin C, and tulsi. This is something in general. When we use Veda Pulse, yes, somebody asked me if the greens that includes all salad. Yes, salad in winter is a no-no. If you are desperate for your salad, you have to put a lot of olive oil. You cannot eat salad in winter. If you want to butter balance, you cannot give it to your butter salads. Okay, if you have your Veda Pulse, in Veda Pulse, we have food recommendations divided in three different columns. The green one is the best for you. The yellow one is the one that you can use sometime, 2-3 times per week. And the pink area is the food located here that you have to avoid. Most people, when they get the results and the recommendations, say, oh my gosh, I'm eating all of this in the pink area, and that's the reason I have this imbalance. So that is a very, very beautiful tool, no? Because people start learning what you're eating, even those are like a superfood, it's not good for you. We have to learn what is better for every single person. What you're eating is, even if you are Vata, and Vata is not the same food because I have another things going on. So this is very specific. That's the reason I love Veda Pulse. Well, let's go through some simple recipes. Like a guy, what you can eat if you are experiencing adrenal fatigue for breakfast. Oatmeal with apples. Apples are not garnish. Non-fruit can be on top of your oatmeal. If you want oatmeal with your fruits, you have to cook your oatmeal and your fruits. There is no topping in Ayurveda. That is something that I want to be very clear, because you have to make all the ingredients cook together so they become like friends. So you can assimilate, digest, it's gonna be nutritive. Because if you put the apple raw on top, that's going to create fermentation. You see, it's not going to help you with your nutrition. Chia seed. With almond meal and spirulina, also you can add maca, that is very good too. Because it's balancing the cortisol. In Ayurveda, we cook the chia. We don't soak overnight oatmeal. We don't soak overnight chia. We cook oatmeal and we cook chia. That is something modern that somebody say, okay, let's do this, and everybody's doing that. No, it's not good for you. That is going to create ama in your body. You cannot digest that. Chia with almond milk and spirulina. Also, if you want to put some fruit that are balancing for your vata, like blueberries, you're going to put the blueberries inside and you're going to cook your chia or your oats with that. Bliss ball with dates and sesame seed and ghee. This is very simple. You're going to put in your processor, dates, sesame seed. Also, you can put some raisin, little ghee, a little cumin. You're going to make a paste and you're going to make a little bolt. You're going to eat that every morning after you had water with lemon. You're going to eat that. That is going to help you. Not only is nutritive, but also it's going to help you with sorry, I read something here and I lost. It's going to help you with your elimination. But remember, you have to have with this hot water or warm water. You cannot have a stray and that's it. Even if you are eating some bars that you are doing healthy at home, you have to take it with warm water. And somebody say oatmeal is not Ayurvedic with fruit. Ayurveda said that if you cook together the oatmeal with the fruit, it's okay. Khichdi for lunch. Khichdi is a perfect food. It's a healing food. It has more than 10 pharmacological effects. Lowering cortisol, I said that maca is great to incorporate in your food. For example, almond milk with maca, that is going to be great for cortisol. At the end of the presentation, I have a tea to reduce cortisol too. Khichdi, the healing food, more than 10 pharmacological effects in your body. It's a complete protein, is easy to digest. And it's the perfect food. You can eat khichdi with by itself. You can add vegetables that is balancing your vata, like roots or zucchinis. Also, if you want to put some greens, you can cook the greens here. And remember to put your ghee. Your vegan, replace it for flaxseed or coconut oil. You have to check if you are good with coconut oil because not too many vatas can digest coconut oil or coconut milk. Salmon rich in omega-3 and omega-6 or tempeh for vegans or no vegans. The only recommendation here is if you are using salmon, you are not going to use starchy. You are not going to use starchy vegetables like potatoes, sweet potatoes, or rice. That salmon, it must go with quinoa, that is a pseudo grain, it's not a grain. And greens, for example, cooked greens. Tempeh, yes, tempeh or tofu, or you can mix it with starch and grains. There is no problem with that. And then you can create a lasagna with veggies like a pumpkin, zucchini, and spinach. There is a new pasta, but can have pasta. With pasta, there is no problems, but if you have problem with gluten, avoid that. But this is just made with the zucchinis, make the layers, and so in between you have a spinach and pumpkin, and on top is cashew cream sauce. That is very simple. You put in your blender, just soak it cashews overnight, and little lemon, little salt, and that's it, little pepper. No more than that you need to make cream sauce. So make it simple. You better say less is better. So less food, combine it, is better for your digestion. Soups. Soups are recommended for dinner. I better recommend at night to have for supper soup. Yes. And your supper is must be at sunset time, no later than that. Liquid potatoes. Leeks is rich in minerals, and potatoes, it has phosphorus too. And the only recommendation here is if you are using leeks, onion, or little ginger, potatoes, garlic, don't forget to add black pepper. Why? Because black pepper is going to help in here, because potato is one of the, is blocking the channels where the nutrition circulation is the nutrition. So potatoes with black peppers are a good match. Any vegetable soup, you can mix veggies. No more than 5 ingredients. Just keep it simple. And if you want to add, like in here, some turkey that is rich in niacin, vitamin B3, Remember not to use starchy veggies like sweet potatoes or potatoes. Okay, if you are using tofu or tempeh, yes, you can do that, or also some beans. But when you are doing some soup with chicken or turkey, just avoid the starchy grains and veggies. Orange soup. This orange soup is not a soup made with orange, it's just the color, okay? So we have here carrot, pumpkin or butternut squash, sweet potatoes, and make this beautiful soup with cardamom, cinnamon, nutmeg. You are going to mix all together, or you're going to change, because when you change the spices or the herbs, the flavor profile is different. So you are going to have different food. Ayurveda doesn't recommend snacks, but if you still want to do that, there are better options like nut butter with sweet potatoes. In this case, for example, here we had Brazilian nuts with sweet potatoes, and you can create a beautiful dip, especially warm in this time. Today is the coldest day of the December. Yes, we reached the 43. It's cold, really cold. So it's better. So my breakfast was today a little oatmeal, and it was so beautiful to eat that warm. You can use any nut butter. If you have almonds at home, the only thing you have to do in order to create your butter is put it in the oven. Don't roast it, just heat it up, the nuts, and then let it sit for a few minutes, put it in your powerful blender, and you're going to create your own butter, nut butter, okay? Banana pudding, room temperature, and with a little cacao. Cacao is rich in magnesium too. And but we don't have to eat very often the cacao, because the liver is not going to be happy. So here you have just banana and cacao, and a little rice syrup. Spices are the key for digestion. So you can add your cinnamon, your cardamom, and you're gonna have a beautiful banana pudding. And don't put in the fridge, please. It's not, we have to remember this. Our digestion started when there is 37 Celsius degrees in your stomach. When you eat, let's say that you prepare the banana pudding, you put it in the refrigerator for 2 hours, it's cold. It's very cold. So when you put that in your stomach, the 37 Celsius degree that is in the stomach is going down. 30, 25, 20, we don't know. What happened in your stomach? Nothing. Because till the temperature is going back to the 37 Celsius degrees, nothing happened in your stomach. There is no enzyme production. It's there, waiting. So that temperature that is not ideal, the only thing that is going to create is fermentation. And after the fermentation, bad things happen. Tiger nut banana muffin. Tiger nut is a tuber and is a great flour from to prepare muffins. How to prepare a healthy muffin? You're going to put your almond flour or the tiger nut flour, and you're going to prepare a thick smoothie with banana. Banana, a little coconut oil, a little water, just a thick smoothie. And then you're going to fold together the smoothie and the flour made with nuts. oven, and that's it. How simple is that? And don't forget to put your cardamom, your cinnamon, your nutmeg. Yes? Okay, so then, basically, what we wanna do? Natural food, looking for natural food. If you want to eat pancakes, don't buy a box. You have to go to your gluten-free flour, your almond flour, tiger nut flour, just put it in your blender with a little water, a banana or apple puree, and that's it. You don't need more than that, a little salt, little cardamom, cinnamon. That's it. You don't need anything else. Natural food, wholesome food. Looking for natural probiotics like kefir, yogurt, those are special for bata, sauerkraut, pickles, kimchi, kombucha, miso, tempeh, tofu. Those are a great probiotic. We don't have to spend a lot of money in order to add probiotics in our diet, okay? Another thing very important in order to support our adrenal glands and also our whole system is to stimulate our agni with Shatara Agni. First thing in the morning, hot water with lemon. Before your meals, ginger, grated ginger with little lemon and honey. If you don't need honey, just put salt. 10 minutes, 5 minutes before your meals, get that. Prepare a shot with ginger, hot water, and lemon, little pinch of salt. That is something that is going to stimulate our acne. So this is very important to keep in mind. Natural wholesome food, natural probiotics, and acne. Keep with our acne high, our Shatara Agni in good shape. Knowing that we have to pacify Vata, you know, to pacify Vata, we need to keep on a schedule. Vata and everybody to keep all the Vatas in everybody on check is having a schedule to wake up and do the activities always in the same order. No, skip food, food time. So practicing the Dinacharya, the daily routine is the best. Self-massage with sesame oil for Vata, especially for everybody now that is the cold weather. It's a magical thing happening when we do the Abhyanga. We don't only activate the circulation of the blood and the lympha, also we create serotonin. So, and we need that, because if we don't have enough serotonin, we are going to wake up at night and we are not be able to fall asleep. Okay, so it's very important to have serotonin and start your day happy with that. Nasya, warm herbal oil for our nostrils. Do some exercise. Practically, we know what situation stresses us. So we have to remove, avoid the situation. When was the last time that you embraced a tree or contemplate a sunset or go to the beach? What do you love to do? Do you have any hobby? Do you paint? Do you write? Do you walk? What do you want to love? What creates love for you? Do you want to listen to soft music? We need activities to create peace of mind. Proper sleep. Yes, go to bed before 10 vatas. And wake up before the sunrise, okay? Give yourself permission to do nothing. Mostly I took my Saturdays. I said, okay, nothing. Even I don't go to shopping. Nothing, nothing at all. I don't want to drive. I don't want to do anything on Saturdays. And it's beautiful. I love to do that. It's a lot of peace. No, there is no pressure. I decide not to do anything, so I have no pressure. Quiet your mind through meditation, yoga, and pranayama. Meditation is going to be part of your daily routine as yoga and pranayama. Yoga, simple sun salutation. If you don't go for that, just forward bend because we have to push apana down, okay? And pranayama. Pranayama. Vata cannot do a lot of pranayama, but yes, it's recommended. The herbal tea to reduce cortisol. Lemon balm, passion flower, chamomile, and hops. Anybody was interested in to have this PowerPoint presentation, just contact me. I want to leave in the last slide my info, so you don't have to write now. But lemon balm, passion flower, chamomile, and hop. You are going to combine, you can put just, what I do is I put in equal amount each, and then I take 1 teaspoon per cup. And I take 4 cups per day. If you want a little more strong, go for more. It's not going to hurt you, okay? Lemon balm, passion flowers, chamomile, and hop. Passion flower also is good for people who are having difficult to digest gluten. Passion flower before your meal that it has gluten, and you can enjoy seeing that you stop getting because you are not digesting the gluten properly. And then we have ashwagandha. Ashwagandha, you make a tea. Another one that I'm going to recommend, so we are going to mix with almond meal, that you are going to make 5 to 10 almonds, well, 1 cup of water. And you are going to blend. Of course, the almonds are going to be soaked overnight, or better, I usually recommend to do it for 32 hours. What I do is I put it in the refrigerator, and every day I replace the water, and I have all the week my almonds to do the almond milk. Ashwagandha with almond milk, 1 teaspoon of ashwagandha, and dates and ghee. That is amazing to start your day like that. Another thing that we can do, I remember now, you can start your day with, grab a ghee. If you made your ghee, very good, congratulations. You're going to put dates without the stone in like a 10 in a jar of 8 ounces. And you're going to put some saffron and some cardamom and cinnamon. And you're going to leave it for 10 days, marinated in 10 days. And every morning you're going to have one, and you eat it and wash it out with warm water. That is going to be great for your adrenal glands. You're going to have energy. You're going to feel happy because the saffron is beautiful to experience joy. So ashwagandha with dates, ginger, perfect because vata need a little stimulation with the acne, and saffron, cardamom, and cinnamon. This in evening hours or in the morning, that is so beautiful for your mind. You're going to feel calm, nourished. That is it's perfect for this moment of the year, and especially to nourish your adrenals and my too. Go to cola for your brain to release the stress. Rhodiola, Rhodiola, I only get it in powder. Yes, and I don't use pills. I always say when you put your herbs in your mouth, from your mouth to your brain, there is a little distance. And if you put a pill here, go to the stomach, then it has to be distributed for your blood and go to your brain. So when you put your brain, your herbs in your mouth, is going directly to your brain, the information and the healing started right away. So rhodiola, you can use rhodiola with your milks. You can make a little tea. You can mix it even with honey and just put it in your mouth and wash it up with warm water. Tulsi. Tulsi is a beautiful herb, holy basil, that is going to keep your mind calm and your spirit satisfied. And chyawanprash. Chyawanprash is like a jelly, so no more peanut butter and jelly. So the jelly is going to be chyawanprash. Chyawanprash is made with, it's a formula. It's like a 45 herbs coming in the chyawanprash and make it I love this. That is give you energy. It's a rasa shine. That means that it's going to rejuvenate your body. It's nutritive for your brain, for your blood. It's going to go to cover all your tattoos. So it's a beautiful thing. And you can eat it with, even just mix it up with milk, if you drink milk or almond milk. And if not, with your toasted bread or just a spoon. I just spoon it and just wash it out with warm water. So that is all the recommendation for now. So thank you so much. And you can contact me through WhatsApp at 954-612-4888 or email me to soniatijero@gmail.com and I can gladly send you this presentation if you have any question. Somebody is not see each page in the screen. Okay, so Josephine, just send me send me information. Somebody asked me if it's okay to get tincture of ashwagandha and rhodiola. Okay, it's going to be, if this is no alcohol base, it's okay. No fruit smoothies for breakfast during winter. No, Christina. Fruit smoothies are now recommended for breakfast, and you can cook your fruit. For example, make a beautiful compote. You can just simmer some apples and pears because they are from the same family. Yes, and or you can bake apples, and you can have warm apples in the morning, or the oatmeal with some fruit cooked together, but no smoothies. No cold smoothies in the morning. Remember that I told you what happened in your stomach, the 37 Celsius degrees. If you are putting first things in the morning, a cold smoothie with fruit and another thing, people tend to put in your smoothie, in the smoothie, 5 to 10 ingredients. Keep it simple. If you're going to do that, please don't put more than 3 ingredients. Because your stomach has no idea what's going on. They cannot make all the action that we need to do in order to digest everything. Remember, in Ayurveda, we don't mix fruits that are not from the same family. Berries are going together. Apples and pears going together. Citrus are going together. We don't mix citrus or banana with berries, or citric with berries. No, berries together, apples and pears from the same family together, banana by itself, melons by itself, we don't mix it. And we don't mix And we don't mix the veggies with the fruits either. So the maximum that I made is water from kale. So I liquefy the kale, I strain, and for summer, I put some blueberries and mint, and that is going to be my smoothie when it's super hot at 4 p.m. Never in the morning. Okay, so if anybody has question, okay, to reduce cortisol, we are going to use maca. Remember that I said that maca, because it balances the cortisol. And also, let me see, I think I have some, I don't remember what I have, but I prepared something just in case, some specific thing. So I want to send you, Anna, send me a text or an email, and I will send more information about that, okay? So thank you so much for your time to join with me in this presentation. Keep safe and enjoy life and meditate and be lovely with everybody. Thank you so much. Thank you for being people from Venezuela, Germany, Lebanon. Thank you very much from Turkey. Wow. Yeah, thank you, everybody. Ireland, Denmark. Wow. France. Bonjour, Shulpuf. Austin, Texas. Latvia. I don't know what is Latvia. Probably is Europe. Eastern Europe, yes, that's right. Okay, perfect. Yeah, you are in, Doctora Cristina. Latvia is Europe, Baltic state. Okay, thank you. Okay, I hope nobody is experiencing adrenal fatigue, but if you do, please implement this information because it really works. If you have the chance to make a beta pulse analysis, check those specific things that I told you, the Vata imbalance, the apana, the high apana and the low prana, the meridian in the liver, in the kidneys, a lot of cortisol and adrenaline in your body, and the low, the total power is low under 800, and the Muladhara chakra, very lack of energy. Thank you so much.